Look at this iPod. This was released in 2004. It's the iPod Classic 4th generation. It has a 20GB hard drive in it. Sadly, the battery isn't really working on this. It gets stuck in a loop when you charge it, of charging, then dying, then charging, and so on. After a while, it does boot up, but it dies pretty quickly. And in this video, I'm going to be fixing the battery. The first thing I did was wipe it down just to clean the surface and the super shiny back. Then I got out a phone repair toolkit. You don't need a big, fancy one, and one like this will do. It needs to have things like a spudger for prying things. I can't find the exact toolkit that I have, but I'll link the brand store in the description. Also, before I continue, please do this at your own risk. Anyway, the first thing that I did was look up a tutorial on how to disassemble this. I definitely think you should look one up if you're doing this so you'll know exactly what to do. I'll link the one that I followed in the description. It said to pry the white plastic away from the metal. I took one of these blue things and started to separate it. Once I got a small opening, I used this thing, similar to a guitar pick, to keep it open. By the way, this isn't that easy. So I tried tons of different things, and the best method was this thing they call a spudger. I was able to go around and separate the whole thing. If you flip the whole iPod upside down, the metal back can pull away from everything else. Be careful because there is a ribbon connector that connects the back piece to the PCB. It's connected right here, and you can use a spudger to remove it. It's pretty difficult, but as long as you're careful, it'll be fine. Then rotate the iPod around, and you'll need to remove this connector. This is the worst step. It's so small and seems to be really jammed in there. I eventually pulled each wire out of the connector and broke away the plastic to get these three wires. Only do that if you're gonna be replacing the battery, not reusing it, because you can't reconnect it afterwards. Then you'll wanna unscrew these two black screws and lift up the little PCB. This is a little weird, but you wanna lift the wires from underneath the board. Now, with a plastic spudger, lift up the battery. You have to use plastic here because if you puncture the battery with metal, it can explode. The adhesive underneath the battery might be hard to remove at first, but should eventually come off. Here's the old battery, and here's the new. This is one I ordered from iFixit because it'll probably be more reliable and safe than some random one off of Amazon. Links in the description. It comes wrapped in this cool paper packaging thing, it's like a honeycomb, and then it's in a box. Looks pretty similar to the original one. Anyway, let's get this into the iPod. I basically lifted up the hard drive, slotted the battery in, and lifted up the board to tuck the wire under. Personally, I don't think there needs to be any more adhesive for the battery because it's a pretty tight fit. You can add some of your own if you want. I screwed the board back in and plugged in that tiny little battery connector. I flipped the iPod around and plugged in the metal back, snapped it back into place, and turn it on. It looks like the battery is around half full, so I let it charge for a while before using it. The repair was successful. Let's listen to some music. It's pretty nice to be able to use an iPod that is 17 years old in 2021. It's like it's brand new, and the battery seems to last a really long time. Even though it was difficult to get the iPod disassembled and the connectors unplugged, I'd say it was worth it. That's pretty much it for this video. Thank you for watching.